Hey guys, welcome to this Mometrix video on fractions. Fractions can be simple or complex. In this video, we'll cover different types of fractions and how to add fractions with different denominators. So, what is a fraction? A fraction is a part of a whole, which means a fraction can never be a whole number. Think of it like this. Our circle is divided into 8 equal pieces. Let's say 3 pieces were filled in. That means that 3/8 of our circle is filled in. The top number is called the numerator. And our bottom number is called the denominator. When saying fractions out loud, the denominator will usually be spoken as the ordinal version of the number. You would say 1/8 instead of 8, or 1/3 instead of 3. Let's take a look at a list of our denominators and see how we would say them. As you can see, there are a couple of exceptions. If our denominator is 2, you could say half instead of second. Or if our denominator is 4, you can say quarter instead of fourth. But either one is acceptable. Hopefully that helps you to understand how fractions are defined and also how to actually say them out loud. But there are different types of fractions. Let's take a look at those. First, we have a proper fraction. A proper fraction always has a numerator, which we looked at, that is smaller than the denominator. Our example that we used before, 3/8. So our numerator, 3, is smaller than our denominator, 8. Some other examples of proper fractions include 4/5. Proper fraction is the opposite of a proper fraction in that the numerator is larger than the denominator. So while 3/8 is a proper fraction, 8/3 is an improper fraction because the numerator is larger than our denominator. Improper fractions are always equal to or greater than 1. That means that 9/9 is an improper fraction since it's equal to 1. There are also mixed fractions, which contain a whole number and a proper fraction. Here's an example. Note that the whole number 2 is followed by the proper fraction 3/4. We also have equivalent fractions. Equivalent fractions are 2 different fractions that name the same number. For example, 6/8 and 3/4 look different, but they're the same. 3/4 is just a simplified or reduced version of 6/8. To simplify 6/8, you just divide the numerator and the denominator by 2 to get 3/4. Now that we know the different types of fractions, we can explore how to add them. If 2 fractions have the same denominator, adding is a breeze. You just add the numerators together, and that gives you the answer. For example, so notice what we did to get 3/4. All we had to do was add from our first fraction, the 1 from our numerator, and from our second fraction, the 2 from our numerator. Add them together to get 3, and we just bring over our 4 from the denominator. Simple. But what happens if the denominators are different? Well, in that case, you have to convert the denominators to be the same. So let's take a look at an example. can't really simplify 3/8 into anything that would easily add with 1/2, but we can do something with 1/2 that we could easily add with 3/8, and that's multiplying 2 by 4, which would give us 8. But whatever we do to our denominator, we also have to do to our numerator. So that would look like this. So our equation now becomes 3/8 plus 4/8 equals 7/8. Subtraction works the same way. If you're subtracting fractions with the same denominator, you can just subtract the top numbers, like in this example. So in this example, all we had to do was subtract our top numerators here, which gave us 2/4, which simplifies to 1/2. Simplifying numbers just makes them easier to work with. But if you're subtracting with a different denominator, you have to make the denominators match, for example. So in this example, 3/8 minus 1/4 is equal to x. We're kind of looking at a same issue like we did over here. We need our denominators to match. So we need to find out what can we do to make our denominators match. Well, in this case, we can multiply 4 times 2. But remember, we have to do the same thing that we do to the denominator, we must do to our numerator. So we can multiply it times 2, and then here's what we get. So once we multiply our second fraction here by 2, we get 3/8 minus 2/8, which gives us 1/8. So these problems were pretty easy because they had either the same denominator or were just really easy to convert. But let's look at one more equation that's a little trickier. So at first glance, it doesn't look like these numbers have much in common such that we would be able to multiply or divide 4 by anything to get 7 or 7 by anything to get 4. So a lot of the times when you have problems like this, what you end up having to do is multiplying this fraction by the denominator of the other fraction. And likewise, we would multiply this fraction by the denominator of this fraction. So here's what that looks like. So after our multiplication, we end up getting a common denominator, which is 28. So now all we have to do is add our numerators together, which that gives us 45 over 28. And that's our answer. With this calculation, we found the least common denominator. The least common denominator is the smallest common number between denominators. Anytime you perform a calculation with different denominators, you must find the least common denominator to solve the problem. So that's our look at fractions. I hope this video was helpful to you. If you enjoyed it, then be sure to give us a big thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for future videos. See you guys next time.